Okay, so probably the most requested support question that I get is, how do you get your tabs to look like that? And how do you actually get the tabs in the first place? And how do you move them around? So let's talk about some of the settings in Lightburn, specifically the windows, the tabs, the size and the size of everything on the screen. So all of these tabs that you see here, these are all windows, okay? You may not have them, so watch. I'm going to close this window here, and you'll see now I have only the library. And if I come up to the top, the easiest thing to do if your tabs get corrupted is to click on window and click right here where it says reset to default layout. That will put your screen back in the default layout like the first day that you downloaded Lightburn. And you'll see down here you have the laser tab and the library. Well, I don't like the laser tab down there, so I'm going to take, and this is the title bar up here, I'm going to click on the title bar and drag that off. I could put it anywhere I want. If I wanted to put it there, I could make it bigger, smaller, but where I want it is up on top. So I'm going to drag it up to the top, and you're going to see that that's going to turn blue. That means it's okay to drop. Let it go, and there it is right there. If I don't like that position, I can just click, hold, and drag it to another position on the tabs. Now, you'll notice that I have no tabs now down here on my library. Now, if I come up to the top right here, you see how it turns into two lines? Well, that's a resize tool. I'm going to click, hold, and drag to drag that up to make it bigger. I usually drag until the top screen starts to move, like that, and I'll leave it right there. You can click and drag on any of these. If you want to make this bigger, you can do that. If you have a lot of tabs open, if you want to make it smaller, you can do that. Everything in here is customizable. Now, let's say I wanted to add something to this. There are two ways to add a tab here. So let's go ahead and get the art library tab. I can either right click on the title bar, and I can click on art library right here, and that will pop up the art library. Or I can go to the window again up at the top and check the button for art library, and that will also bring up the art library. So now with my art library up, where do I want it? I want it on top of my library, so I'll drag it over. Now I will say that Lightburn does not play well with laptops, with some laptops. So on some laptops, it's almost impossible to dock these over here. So you may have to open and close them as you go. But now I want to add another tab over here to this section. So I'm going to right click on the title bar, and I'm going to go to variable text. And when I click on that, see there's no check there? I'm going to click on it and put a check there, and it now appears as a tab on this section right here. Now to move on to some other settings, if you come up here to the gears and click on the settings, what you'll find in here is your visual grid spacing over here. Right now you can see my little squares on the screen are set to 10 millimeters. You would set this to either millimeters or inches right up here, depending on which one you work in. I work in millimeters. So I have mine set to 10. I usually have it set to 1. I'll change that to 1. And you can also set the contrast of the grid. You can do low, medium, or high contrast. Let's switch it to medium for this demonstration, so you'll see the changes when I click OK. Over here, if you're on a diode laser, you want to be on millimeters per minute or anything on this side. If you're on a CO2, you want to be on millimeters per second or anything on this side. This is your snapping, snap to object, snap to grids. I like to have that on most of the time. Unless I'm doing precision positioning, then I will turn snap to objects off. But usually I have both of these on. This is the shape movement increments using your control and arrow, your arrow key, and your shift arrow. So depending on the number that you put in here, will determine how far it moves. Like this would be with the arrow key itself. Let's say we want the arrow key to move the graphic five millimeters. We'll just put five in there. Shift arrow would be 20. Control and arrow would be, let's just make that one like that. And this is pretty much everything you need to know about the settings in here. And let's cover the sizes. You also see the toolbar icon size. Those are these icons right here. You can grab this slider bar and drag it over a little bit and make those larger if you can't see them. I'm going to put them back where they were. There's also font size in here, which are these fonts right here. And we can also make those larger. When you let go of the mouse, you can see the change in the font size. I'm going to put it back to 14 like that. And that's it for this window as far as controls are concerned. Now I am going to add as an afterthought in the gear icon up here, you do have something called file settings. And if you use SHX fonts, you will have a path to that. An SHX font is, I guess, antiquated fonts, the fonts that launched the internet, line fonts, very basic fonts. Some of them look really nice in engraving. So if you download some SHX fonts, put them in a folder, and then click on this and browse to that folder. And that's pretty much all you really need to know about this tab right here. But I also did want to mention that with the toolbars, these toolbars can also be moved. So you can grab, let's say we grab, see these dotted lines right here? If we pass our mouse over the dotted lines, all of them have dotted lines. All of these different separators, these are separators. We can grab that and move this toolbar wherever it is that we want. So if you wanted to move it down to the bottom, you can do that. We'll move it back up to the top. If you wanted to move, let's say, one that you use quite frequently, which would be this one, if you wanted to move it to its own line, you can do that as well. If you don't have enough space on the right side, some screen resolutions don't. I'm going to put it back up here, but all of these can be moved. You can move them wherever you like and customize your screen any way that you want. So I wanted to add just a little bit to that particular part of the video. Now you can see I've gone to 1 millimeter in a medium contrast, and every one of these boxes in here is a 1 millimeter spacing. Another thing too, up on the top, you have this arrange toolbar. I personally don't like this, it's for beginners. I will right click on the white space right next to it, and I will take the check mark out of arrange right down here. That will make that toolbar go away. Now I'll right click again, and I'll come back down here and I'll put a check mark in arrange long so that I can get all of the tools in Lightburn positioning tools. So I just wanted to make this video today. This is the number one requested support email, text message, phone calls that I get from people, is they can't figure out how to arrange things on their screen. So I wanted to make a short video today. I hope you enjoyed it. And I really enjoyed making this because I think this is going to keep a lot of my support messages down. I have a hard time answering them all right now, especially with all the testing going on in the laser lab with the 20 watts. So I hope this video helped you. I had a lot of fun making it for you. And as always, I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.